memo understanding with our Secretary Baldrige. Hope that we can take advantage of that to increase our market share at NTT. We're all very pleased.
Thank you very much. Before I start talking, Mr. President, our President, Nakasone called me upon to his office, and he specially ordered you devote your full effort to proceed the procurement procedure within the United States as far as possible.
Well,
he strongly ordered me as his special order.
Well, I think very much of him. We've just had a very fine meeting here at the Williamsburg Summit, but I am greatly, greatly impressed with my friend, Mr. Nakasone.
He especially called me upon just after he returned from that summit meeting.
Well, I'm glad to hear that.
Thank you very much. I am very much honored. And I have getting now the realistic good hope. I can cope with the requirement from Mr. Secretary Baldrige, Ambassador Brock, Mr. Gibbons was. I have met them in Tokyo, and I could have fortunately long time to discuss how we can solve this problem. And I'm bringing down here my some practical thinking way. So I'm going to meet them again here in Washington while I'm here.
Yes.
So I hope I can smooth that as far as possible.
Well, I join you in that hope, and I'm sure we can.
Thank you very much.
All right.
Yeah, thank you.
I'm also actively involved with the Eureka Kite.
Well, I'm glad to hear that.
Yes. Activities in Japan.
He is my very important secretary concerning the relationship between the United States.
Well, my brother has written me about the wonderful meetings and the warmth and hospitality
yes.
that he ran into there. And I know that our little college is very proud of what has been worked out.
So it's a moving now.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you.
Hello, Mr. President. How are you? How are you, sir?
Achieve a START agreement. And as I weigh changes, which we may wish to make in the START position during the course of the negotiations, I wanted to hear your views also on this same subject, because I know there's something you're interested in. And now I'm going to call on Kevin Farley.
Well, thank you all for being here. And I
You know, we had a meeting of the National Security Council this morning to discuss future steps in the START negotiations, and it was a good roundtable. We also discussed our ongoing analysis of the concept of a guaranteed, a mutual guaranteed build-down. And I remain fully committed to the promise that I made to develop build-down options which could help us achieve our objective of significant reductions in nuclear arms. And today, I want to give you a status report on our work and the program and progress, and also to hear from you your own thoughts on the issues associated with our work. I must say, on the build-down, we found out that there are a lot of technical points that have to be covered, so that will become a boomerang. As for example, if we are modernizing and building down and they are already so far ahead of us in modernizing and therefore don't need to add something, they're not going to be building down. But I don't think there's going to be any problem in finding ways. I think it will be a sizable help in the program of getting mutual reduction. And right now, I'd like to turn to Bud McFarland here for a briefing on some of what all took place today.
I know we're running out of time and I'm late because now I
Hello, George.
Hello, Max.
George, nice to see you today.
Well,
Deck was present.
Speaking for all of us, all the support that you've been on so many things, and we haven't repeated any of our intention to still dedicate to the interests of Israel. We'll hear from you.
Mr. President, the purpose of this meeting is to reestablish the leadership of the Republican Jewish Coalition as a result of the Al Spiegel resignation. We attend.
Just fine. Good to see you. Well, why don't we come in for a moment here so they can get some lunches. Hi.
Ms. Diaz.
We're going to do an act together.
Yeah.
I want you to please. It's got it all warm for you.
Oh, good. Must be some
time. Well, before we dig in on things, though, thank you for your resolution and support and all the help that you've been in the defense matter. We appreciate it.
Trying to get something done on the country's behalf. Yours as well. Okay. It's been hard to get some folks to focus on. I'm kind of distracted by other things that are going on, as you know. But
yeah, it's kind of full plate.
Well, the Central American world is just crazy. On this one, I appreciate the opportunity to speak with you on it. I could not have welcomed your speech more. And it strikes me that you've crossed something of a Rubicon, which I think is a good one to cross. As you know, there are critics out there, speaking of Star Wars and Darth Vader.
Yes.
And all of that.
And you know, I never even indicated what type of weapon it might be. I am not a scientist, I had no idea, but they automatically, all of a sudden now, you would think that I specifically said laser and satellite and all of that.
Well, it's a funny situation that
Well, I know started, and I know we always want to run over to the candidate because the senior fixed up the students out there. But there's not going to be any waiting. First, we've got two subjects here. The first one is the Williamsburg Summit. But let me just take a minute and see one thing that I think is very different. I won't say any more because I don't want to cut in on what we're done, they say. But this was the first one in all the 9 years of summits that have taken place in which we tried something different. It was an American idea, and it met with great approval on the part of all of our allies. The summits in the past have been a kind of formalized structure in which they go around the table and every head of state has something to say, and they've already written a communique before the meeting starts that will be released when they're over, that tells everyone what they did, only they wrote it before we did it. But this time, we communicated with them in advance and told them we thought it ought to be a round table in which we take up all the issues that are of concern to all of us and throw them out on the table for everybody to have an app. And they loved it, and that's what we did. And we got agreement. In fact, we stayed on the subject until we got agreement, and not by a majority vote or anything. It was going to be total consensus. And I think the alliance is stronger than it's ever been as a result. They all left enthused over what had taken place. Everybody aligned in their support of how together we've got to meet the economic problems, how together we've got to bring down the worldwide inflation, not just in one country, but we've got to bring our policies into the conditions. And as I say, it was a very heartening experience. I'm very happy. You know, I don't know, maybe you all know this secret, just this last basketball out there, but you know what, I remember when I was in college, we lost by one basket to the conference championship. The score was 36-34. Now, of course, the scores are in the hundreds. But in addition to the height of the players and all, if you want to know the other city, I found this out some years ago. The ball is now 2 inches too small.
I wonder if the hoop is the same size.
The players are also about 10 inches taller, though.
Yes. Okay. I found that out when I put a basket up on the garage at home for a son who's about 8 years old. And I stood up for it, didn't I? I just sent my insulin. I didn't do this when I was young. And I was telling somebody that was when I found that. It's one of those shots that used to roll around the ring and come out over because, well, basketball, you know, you really had to shoot those two hands.
Just
going to
give
me
some lessons down there.
No, I guess they thought a basketball and I had a jersey over there.
I hope you notice, Al, that we have you on the president's left hand. I want to be on his right side. You
know? I think it's the Baltimore man to be able to go out and say that.
The only thing I can comment on that is I'm in my usual spot in the middle.
There'll be another meeting where they'll be invited.
There.
Mr. President, are you going to see that Johnny learns to read? Are you going to see that all the children will really learn to read when they go to public school now, college?
Well, that's, I think, really one of the purposes of the commission report.
Thank you.